Today I am going to show you how to download the Selenium standalone server, and also I am going to show you how to download the driver executable files for Gecko driver, and how to download the for Chrome driver and IE driver. Let me start. Okay, and introductions about Selenium. So Selenium 4 does not support for client server application, and also it will not support for any standalone application. For example, standalone application is, for example, if you have a calculator, that is a standalone application we cannot do the automation for the using Selenium automation. So Selenium can be downloaded from the below website. This is I am going to share you, and so let me show you how to download this one. Go to the official website called as Selenium Dev. So go to the downloads, click on downloads options, and you will find the option called as Selenium standalone server. This is the stable version of this one. You have to click on it and download from this site. So let me show you. So if you want to download and customize the source code from the following, I have following site means. So this will also I am going to share you this link. So if you want to see like source code of Java or Python, go to this website and view the source code of this. So Selenium supports for the different languages such as Java, C Sharp, Ruby, Python, JavaScript. These are the languages supported by Selenium. Now, so what are the flavors of Selenium is? So Selenium contains these four components: Selenium Core, Selenium RC, Selenium WebDriver, and Selenium IDE. Selenium IDE also contains, so Selenroid means it can do automation only for Android. So if you are using Appium, so it will support for automation for both mobile. Mobile automation for Android and iOS devices. So now, so what are the advantages of Selenium is, Selenium supports only for web-based application, and it is free and open source tool, and Selenium supports for different languages such as Java, Python, JavaScript, etc. These are the languages supported by Selenium, and also Selenium supports for multiple browsers. That means it supports Chrome browsers, IE browsers, and Firefox browsers. And coming to the what are the drawbacks of Selenium means, it does not support client server and standalone application. It does not support for CAPTCHA or any animation related application and graphics. This will not support. Now, so for learning Selenium, so what are the software is required means, so we need, these are the softwares. One, we should require JDK. One should require Eclipse for IDE. One, we have to download the Selenium standalone server. So what I shown to the official website, you go there and you have to download from the Selenium standalone server. And also we require browsers, and we should also require for browser specific driver executable files. So that means for Firefox browsers we require Gecko driver .exe file we should require, and Chrome browsers and Internet Explorer also we require. Also we need one any application. Now I already informed these are the steps I have written over here. You just follow this one. Go to the official website, and the website will be going to navigate, and then you have to find one Selenium standalone application. You have to click on that option and download from your system. So now and also, and how to download the driver executable files. These links I am going to share you in the below links. So I am going to share you these links called as Gcode driver link. I am going to share you and Chrome browser and IE browser, those driver executable link I am going to share you. So if you want to download from the official website, means go to the official website. So you will find the below section browsers. Click on the browsers, go to the documentation. The page will be going to navigate and you will see Gcode driver release. You will see this latest version of this, and below that you will find the Gcode driver based on your Windows. If you are using Windows 32 or 64-bit, based on that you are going, which your operating system is there, you have to download from the particular your operating system. Now, so let me tell you, these are the steps I have written here, you just follow that one. Now, what is the architecture of Selenium? Okay, architecture of Selenium WebDriver, we have four components. One is language binding and server, jar file and driver and browser. Selenium architecture of Selenium WebDriver is, this is very important questions for if you are attending any interviews, this question will, they will ask definitely. So they will ask like what is the Selenium WebDriver architecture. You need to explain all these four points. Like these are the points enough to explain to interviewer. So Selenium supports for multiple coding languages like Ruby, Java. These are the languages supported by Selenium. Now, like language bindings, server jar files, driver, browsers. Selenium supports for multiple coding languages. Each language has its own bindings and which communicates with a WebDriver API. The WebDriver API performs the actions on the browser. So by using the browser's specific drivers for using JSON wire protocol, these are the client bindings will communicate to a server, and server will perform the actions on the browser with the help of drivers. So I will show you this in the later. So Selenium supports for, there are like different types of languages. Okay. So as I already informed, and next, these and the client and the client server language bindings, these client server bindings will communicate with a server and will perform the actions on the browser with the help of drivers. So while communicating from server to the browser, it is a protocol called as JSON wire protocol. So JavaScript, that means JavaScript JavaScript object notation. So I will show you how to create the project and how to add the jar files and driver executable files. So go to the new and then Java project, and then create a Java project over here. Because I already created the Java project. So inside the source folder, you need to create one package. So go to the right click on the source. You will find the package. So create the package name, and also then right click on the package. Then you have to create one class name, because I already created. So as I said, right click on the project name. So this is my project name. Right click on it and go to the new. So click on the folder, and then you have to create the folder name as a software I created here, and add the add the driver executable files here. And if you, after adding, copy and paste it over here. So after adding, just right click on this one. So server Selenium standalone server, go to the build path, add the build path, because I already added. So these are the steps I have written over here. just follow the steps, it will be very helpful.